In this video, I'll explain the two-step verification process for your Google account. You may want to do this if you get a warning message saying someone has accessed your account from a country you've never been to. If it can happen to me, it can happen to anyone. If you ever get a red warning message at the top of your Gmail screen that looks like this, "We believe your account was recently accessed from Poland." Here's what you can do to add another level of security to your Google account. Step 1. Sign out of all your open Google sessions. You can do this by clicking the text "Show details and preferences" in the actual warning message, or you can scroll down to the bottom right corner of your Gmail screen and click "Details." You should see a button saying "Sign out all other sessions." This will log you out of all Google-related accounts on any computer or smartphone anywhere in the world. Pretty smart. Step 2. Implement the two-step verification process. Go to the top right corner of your Gmail screen and click the drop-down menu by clicking on your email address. Click Account Settings. On the next screen, look under Personal Settings and next to Security. You should see a link for using two-step verification. Go ahead and click that. Step 3. From here, Google will walk you through everything you need to do. Basically, you're going to enter your cell or landline phone number. Once two-step verification is turned on, every time you sign in to a Google account with your password, a text message will be sent to your phone with a verification code. You'll need to type in that code in order to finish the logon process. You can choose to have the computer remember that code for 30 days, so you don't have to do it every time. Google will also generate backup verification codes that you should write down or print out. You'll need to provide a backup phone number. This could be a cell phone or a landline. You can choose to have verification codes sent via text message or computerized voice recording. But wait, there's more! If you have a smartphone or you use Google Chrome Bookmark Sync, the last thing you'll need to do is have Google generate an application-specific verification code. This application-specific code should be printed out or written down. You'll need to enter this into your smartphone or Google Chrome web browser if you plan on using Google-related accounts there. You only have to enter the application-specific verification code once.